ועכשיו לראיון מיוחד עם בן שפירו, עיתונאי וסופר, ואחד הקולות הבולטים והפופולריים בימין האמריקאי. כתבנו ספי פישמן, אתה עוקב מקרוב אחרי בן שפירו, ומפרשן הוא הפך למגסטאר.
כן, דנה. בן שפירו הוא יהודי אורתודוקס, ואחד מאנשי התקשורת הבולטים ביותר בתקשורת האמריקאית כיום. סתם שיהיה לנו ככה כמה נתונים מספריים, יש לו למעלה מ3 מיליון עוקבים ברשת הפייסבוק, בנוסף לזה יש לו למעלה מ1 מיליון עוקבים ברשת הטוויטר, והוא פשוט מחוזר ברמות. לא עובר כמעט שבוע שהוא לא נמצא או ברשת CNN או ברשת פוקס או אפילו בשתיהן ביחד. בנוסף על כל הדברים האלה, בן שפירו הוציא כ10 ספרים, שהמטרה שלהם למעשה הייתה לתת מענה אינטלקטואלי לעם הימני, הרפובליקני השמרן שבארצות הברית, שהמטרה בספרים האלה היא בעצם לתת סוג של קונטרה לתעודה העוצמתית של השמאל הליברלי בארצות הברית שמגיע מתוך האקדמיה ומתוך התקשורת האמריקאית, שהם ידועים כמאוד ליברליים ומאוד שמאלנים. ויחד עם זאת, בן הוא פשוט בן אדם שכזה, שהוא בא ומופיע והוא ידוע כתומך ישראל מאוד מאוד נלהב, והוא כמעט תמיד מגיע לאולפנים בכדי להציג את הצד הישראלי.
אוקיי, תודה ספי. אז עכשיו נגיד שלום לבן שפירו. מיסטר שפירו, thank you so much for joining us.
No, thanks for having me.
After President Trump recognized Jerusalem as Israel's capital and the sanctions against the Palestinians, do you think his new methods in handling the conflict will make a change in the Palestinians' approach to peace eventually?
Well, I mean, I don't think the Palestinian approach to peace ever changed. I just think that the sucker in the White House did. So I think that the Palestinians always had the same approach to peace, which was act in violence and then profess peace publicly. And President Obama was willing to buy into that logic, and President Trump is not, to his great credit. So, you know, the fact that the President of the United States is finally saying what is true, which is that the Palestinians are essentially not a peace partner to Israel, I don't know if that's going to change Palestinian behavior dramatically, but it's certainly going to prevent the Palestinians from gaining any major political victories during this time period. And between that and the fact that the Saudis, the Jordanians, the Egyptians could not care less about the political aspirations of Mahmoud Abbas and the Palestinian terror campaign, I think that you know, Abbas is sort of boxed in.
And how does the American people see this pro-Israeli policy warm approach of President Trump's towards Israel? The Democrats are not so happy with it.
Well, I mean, I think that most Americans, certainly on the right, are very happy with it. On the left, they've used Trump as a polarizing figure no matter what. So the Democratic Party has moved significantly to the left on Israel, anti-Israel in many ways. They were considering making the head of the Democratic National Committee a guy who is Minnesota Congressman Keith Ellison, who is openly anti-Israel, who voted against funding for the Gaza War, who was a friend of Louis Farrakhan, or at least used to hang out with folks from the Nation of Islam and promote them. So the Democrats have been moving in an anti-Israel direction for a pretty long time, and I think that that's reached culmination with President Trump simply because they'll oppose anything Trump does.
It's a new era of Trump administration, and with an Israeli right-wing government. Do you think that President Trump will support annexation of Judea and Samaria?
I mean, they should certainly apply sovereignty wherever they're planning on applying sovereignty, and they better do it now, because the fact is that if Trump leaves office and Democrats take over, then it's going to be very difficult for them to do that in the face of American intransigence. So now is the time for Israel to make whatever moves it's hoping to make for the foreseeable future in terms of proclaiming territorial integrity, ensuring the annexation of areas that it should have formally annexed years ago.
In another matter, according to a recent research, only 27% of the Democrats identify with Israel and with 50% assimilation. Where do you see this American Jewry-Israel relation going? Do you think that this partisan gap is becoming dangerous for us?
I mean, again, I think that it's become very polarized along political lines. American Jewry is very much to the left, and American Jewry is also not particularly Jewish, meaning it's not a particularly observant group of people. They don't care particularly much about the history of Israel or the biblical value of Israel. They don't observe anything really regarding Judaism. They're more ethnic Jews who are on the political left and atheistic by nature. And so it's not supremely surprising that they don't see tremendous value in Israel. But obviously there's a gap opening that's pretty dangerous for Israel and the United States, this partisan gap that didn't used to exist in quite as high numbers.
Okay, Ben Shapiro, let's hope for more years of warm friendship between Israel and the United States. Thank you.
No, thanks. I appreciate it. Be well.